Grant, we pray you, that your servant may rest at peace in this grave, until that day when you, the resurrection and the life, enrich her with life made new. May she, in the light of your countenance, behold eternal light in heaven.
You poor old Auntie Sylvie. Whenever I smell cabbage boiling, I'll think of us.
What a way to go. Run over. Twice. On two consecutive buses.
Typical, isn't it? You hang about for ages, then two come at once. I hate funerals. They're so depressing.
They're meant to be. You could hardly have a DJ in a puppet show, could you?
Well, you take the Irish. They celebrate death. You know, with wakes and that. They've got the right idea.
If it makes you feel better, we'll jig back to the motor now he's finished.
See you, Silver. Take care of yourself, love.
Excuse me. Tracy? Sharon?
Yeah?
I'm an old friend of your Auntie Sylvie's. She often spoke about the two of you. I recognised you from her pictures.
Oh.
I just wanted to say how sorry I am. Sylvie was a good friend to me over the years.
Tell very much.
Anyway, nice to have met you.
You know, I swear she knew her days were numbered.
Oh, yeah.
A few days ago, she made me promise that if anything happened to her, I was to get in touch with you both.
Aunt Sylvie had the gift. She could see the future coming.
Yeah? Shame it didn't work on them buses.
She asked me to give you this.
It's a key.
Well done, Sherlock.
It's a key to a safety deposit box. Victoria Station.
What's Sylvie doing with a safety deposit box?
Perhaps she wanted to stash away the family heirlooms. Here, Trace, we could have an inheritance.
Don't talk daft.
It's possible, isn't it? Here, mate, did she say... Where's he gone?
There he is.
Oi! Oi, hold up!
Sharon! This is Walthamstow Cemetery, not Petticoat Lane Market.
It don't matter, does it? Trace, we could be on the verge of wealth and riches beyond our wildest dreams. I begged you the tiara.
For the last time, Aunt Sylvie never had a pot to piss in.
There's only one way to find out. Let's play Family Fortunes.
Money, money, money. Must be funny in the rich man's world. Money, money, money. Always sunny in the rich man's world. All the things I could do.
Please, God, let it be diamonds. Oh, that ratness crap, either.
So much for her inheritance. The old bat's left us her gas bill.
There's a note and all. Dear girls, by the time you read this, I will have shuffled off this mortal coil. If, on the other hand, I'm still alive and you are a couple of tea leaves, then get your stinking hands off my property, you toe rags.
She always had lovely way with words.
For many years, I've carried with me a secret about the two of you and your natural parents. The truth is, I knew who they were. When your mum, God rest her soul, adopted you both, she made me swear to keep stum. But now I'm gone, it's up to you to decide for yourselves. Everything you need to know is in the envelope. Love, Sylvie. I say we open it.
And I say we burn it.
Don't be a lemon. Our parents' names in there.
Mum and Dad were our parents.
They're gone, Trace. We ain't got no one now.
No? What about Daryl and Chris?
In case you've forgotten, Butch Casserole and the Sundial Skipper are doing a 12-stretch at one of Her Majesty's holiday camps.
I don't care. I still don't want to know, all right?
No, it's not all right. I want to open
and
it.
And I don't.
And because you're the eldest, you
That's
get your
right.
Oh, as usual.
Have I called it a bad time?
Yes.
Oh, good. I love to see working-class women bicker. It's so Albert Square.
Listen here, yo-yo knickers. I am not in the mood to be patronised by you, all right?
Very good, Sharon. A three-syllable word and used in the correct context. You should apply to join MenCap.
I think you mean Mensa.
I know what I mean. Now, girls, I have an important announcement. Very soon, Marcus and I are to celebrate our silver wedding anniversary. And to mark the occasion...
The Queen's going to present him with the Victoria Cross for bravery.
We are going to throw the party of the year. And I will be the belle of the ball.
Even Big Ben ain't got a bell that old.
I think you're a hypocrite, Dorian.
What do you mean?
Well, if your guest list was to include half the blokes you've had since we've known you, you'd have to hold the party at Wembley Stadium.
Well, I may have succumbed to the odd dalliance.
Odd dalliance? You've spent more time staring up at ceilings than Michelangelo.
Tracy, you exaggerate. Well, maybe not. Anyway, I want this party to be the highlight of the Chigwell social calendar.
That shouldn't be too difficult. Your only competition's the annual rugby club disco, otherwise known as the Pukathon.
Well, not so, Sharon. As luck would have it, our anniversary falls on the 18th, the very day that low-rent bitch, my very best friend Melanie Fishman, celebrates her birthday.
What, and she's also having a party?
Exactly.
Oh, so all this is about keeping up with the Fishmans.
Keeping up? Oh, no. I fully intend to trounce that white trash into oblivion.
Well, I think it's an insult to the sanctity of marriage.
Then you won't mind not being invited, will you?
Nice one, Trace. You've just talked yourself out of a Buckshee booze-up.
Oh, don't get smug, Sharon. You're hardly A-list material yourself.
I'll be coming, won't I?
Sharon. If I was that eager to embarrass myself, I'd become a contestant on Stars in Their Eyes.
I take it that's a no.
Nothing gets past you, does it?
Well, we don't want to go to your poxy party anyway.
No, it's nothing personal, Tracy. I mean, should I ever host a good old Cockney knees-up with whelks and pies and scruffy old flatulent men singing ditties about the Second World War, you'd be the first to know.
Well, now you've given us your uninvite, you can sling your hook. We've got things to discuss. Private things.
Hold up, Trace. It might help to get the opinion of an outsider. Even if she's a prat.
This sounds juicy. What's going on?
In that envelope are the names of our real parents. I want to open it.
And I don't.
And because you say no, it means we don't.
I don't want to open it. I don't want to open it.
Yeah, because you're the eldest, you're also the first.
Torn apart by the past they cannot escape. This could be wonderful material for my next novel.
No,
why do you always have the last word?
That's why.
What do you think, Dor?
Open it. Go on.
No. I'd feel disloyal.
Oh, that soon wears off, trust me.
Come on, Trace. Mum and Dad wouldn't mind us finding out who our real parents are after they're dead, would they?
Strange as it seems, I think I actually know what she's talking about.
See? Come on, Trace, please.
All right.
Oh, I can't wait.
You won't have to. You ain't invited. Nothing personal.
But I...
Shut the door, please, Dorian. And make sure you're on the other side of it. Here we go. Blimey, Trace. It's our real birth certificates. Do you want the good news or the bad news?
The good news.
The good news is our mum's name is Mavis Bullock. And she comes from Chiswick.
What's the bad news?
The bad news is she's dead, Trace. Over 10 years ago. Here's an obituary cutting from the local paper.
What about our dad?
Oh, my good God.
What is it?
Mum and Dad weren't married, Trace.
Oh, lovely. First we're a pair of bullocks, now we're a couple of bastards.
And lucky ones at that. Trace, you're never going to believe who our old man is.
Who?
It's...
Yeah?
George Hamilton.
Who?
You know, the actor. The one with a suntan, always in Hello magazine.
Yes, I know who the George Hamilton is, Sharon.
Well, of course you do, he's our dad.
Don't be so stupid, he's American.
So what? Americans can have babies, Trace. See for yourself.
Father's name, George Hamilton. Yeah, on both of them.
Look what it's got down for his occupation. Actor. I always knew there was something different about us. Something special.
Get a grip, Sharon. It's a coincidence. It's a common name, isn't it?
No. It all fits into place. George flitting round London doing a spot of acting. Yeah, he must have had a thing going with her mum.
Sharon, the chances of the George Hamilton being our father have got to be 1 in 1,000,000.
Maybe so. But it's worth doing a spot of detective work to find out, isn't it?
Yes, Mrs. Hamilton. I know your husband's dead, but did he ever know a Mavis Bullock? Hello? Hello? And another one bites the dust. Literally, in this case.
God bless Fat Stan, eh? His son done us a right good turn hacking into the electoral registers for us.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, cheers, Stan. Yeah, I owe you one, mate. No, not one of them, you dirty lech. Morning, Vicar!
Ah! What's happened?
Trace, I've got brilliant news. Fat Stan's had all his tickets out, mates, checking out all the George Hamiltons that weren't in the phone book. The ones we couldn't get hold of.
And?
And the final results are... 14 have kicked the bucket. 12 are waiting for their voices to break. 10 have never heard of Mavis Bullock. 6 have never heard of Chiswick. 3 are impotent, 2 are black, and 1's living in Northampton with a choreographer named Gordon. Well, you see what this means, didn't you? That's it. We've eliminated them all.
We can't have.
We have. Here's the proof. George is our dad.
Sharon, any one of them could have been lying. Skeletons in the closet and all that.
It don't disprove he's our dad, does it?
No.
Right, but... now, what we've got to do is confront him with the facts.
Hang about. I'll just put my coat on.
There's got to be some way of getting in touch with a bloke.
How? He lives in America.
Shame them Uber tickets never turned up.
My God, look at the state of you both. You look like you should be sitting in a doorway selling copies of The Big Issue.
For your information...
Excuse me, I'm wanted on the mobile. Hello? Oh, Monsieur Raymond. It's Monsieur Raymond, Essex foremost function coordinator.
That's poncish for caterer.
You got my message. Kill the coq au vin. We'll have salmon en croûte instead. The fishmen's are having what? Beluga caviar? Oh. Well, we'll have it too. Loads of the stuff. Spread it on with the trowel, Raymond. The cost? How much can little fish eggs cost these days? How much? Yes, I'll get back to you, Raymond. Ciao. Damn, damn, damn.
Why can't a woman be more like a man?
Do I take it that keeping up with the Fishmans isn't going as swimmingly as one had hoped?
I order Moët & Chandon. Melanie orders Krug. I order canapés. She orders truffles. That woman is definitely starting to rain on my parade.
Sounds to me like she's peeing on it from a great...
She's even got celebrity guests. Lionel Blair and half the Arsenal team have promised to attend. Do you have any idea of the sort of money it takes to book a star of the calibre of Lionel Blair?
No. Give us a clue.
Serves you right for not inviting us to your party.
Yeah, and us having a famous dad and all.
What?
You heard? Me and Tracy are celebrity children.
Really? I didn't know King Kong had been allowed to mate.
You'll be laughing the other side of your mush when you find out who it is.
Are you serious? Who?
Should we tell her, Trace?
Nah. You can come to my party.
We'll think about it.
Good. Now spill the beans. Who is it?
George Hamilton.
I'm sorry.
George Hamilton. What's so funny?
George Hamilton is your father. Slim, suntan, gorgeous George Hamilton.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, my God, they'll have to rewrite the laws of genetics.
Show her the birth certificates, Trace.
Yes. Well, there must have been
147 of them, actually. And we've checked every one of them out.
But it's not possible. George Hamilton has been out with some of the world's most beautiful women. Joan Collins. Elizabeth Taylor.
Mavis Bullock.
I don't believe it. I have adored him ever since I was a teenager. The man is a bona fide sex god.
Why, you? Don't talk dirty about our dad.
It isn't possible.
It is. And there's the proof.
Look, Cheryl, we don't know for sure.
No. But you must find out, because if this is true, it could change your lives.
Our lives don't want changing.
You speak for yourself.
You have to get in touch. Now, George always spends the summer in Bel Air. That's Hollywood.
Hollywood? We can't afford the fare to Cricklewood.
I might be able to help. I have been secretly hoarding Marcus's air miles from his business trips.
They're Marcus's?
Only legally. I might have enough stashed away to get you to the States.
Are you saying that you'd pay for us to go to America?
Of course. Think of it as a token of friendship. No, better still, look on it as charity.
What's the catch?
There isn't one. No, I could do with a break myself.
There's the catch.
Well, that's settled then.
Hollywood, here we come.
Forget it, Trace. You ain't going to LA and that's final. The place is crawling with criminals.
Be all right.
That's what Rodney King said just before he popped out for a packet of fags. What about little Garfy, eh? Huh? You can't just abandon him.
Little Garfy's just turned 18. He's away on a skiing trip with his mates.
I don't like it, Tracy. It could be dangerous.
He'll be all right. He's had lessons on the dry slopes.
I meant you.
Look, I have to do this, Daryl. Please.
You don't honestly think you're George Hamilton's daughter, do you?
No. I don't know for sure, do I? That's why I have to go, to find out for myself.
I always dreamed that one day you and me would go to the States, together like.
We will, one day.
Time I get, Macaulay Culkin would be president.
Look, if you really don't want me to go, Darryl, I won't.
Nah, I couldn't do that to you, Tracy. But take good care of yourself, eh? Los Angeles, eh? You'll have a riot there, Sharon.
That's not funny, Chris.
Well, it's all a bit much to get used to. Going to America, eh? George Hamilton. Boy, it's exciting, isn't it?
After being married to you, Chris, Emmerdale Farm's exciting.
Look, if this geezer really is your father, you realise what this means, don't you? We'd be rich.
No. I'll be rich.
Yeah, but you're my wife. Mm.
And you're in the nick, so hard luck.
George Hamilton. My father-in-law. Hey, I bet me and him got loads in common.
Chris, George Hamilton is a renowned movie star, an international playboy.
Yeah.
And you are a tosspot. Hurry up. Two pints of lager that need recycling.
Didn't.
I did. Twice.
How could you? I'm virgin of all airlines.
I know, isn't it ironic?
Most people get their nuts in little packets. Not her, though.
I've always wanted to join the Mile High Club. Hopefully that should earn me honorary life membership.
I doubt it, you daft tart. We ain't taken off yet. We're still on the flipping runway.
Oops. So we are. Anyway, see you both later.
Where are you going there?
Well, I'm off to the upper class section. You really didn't expect me to stay here amidst social groups D, E and Ford Orion. I'm off to find a nice wealthy tycoon. Ciao. Have a good flight. To make your acquaintance. I'm Dorian. Dorian Green. And you are?
My name's Richard.
Mind if I call you Dick? Of course you don't, Dick. Now, have you flown before, Dick? Don't. I do it all the time. Flying, that is.
Welcome to the Hotel California.
Oh, well. Cheap and cheerful. Come on, Dora, better get a move on.
Me? No, this is your accommodation. I'm staying at the Mondrian. The top people's hotel.
You.
We'll rendezvous in the bar at 9 o'clock. And Sharon, try to dress a little more cosmopolitan. Drive on. Stop mucking about.
Hello.
my house was to walk in right now, it'd be love at first sight.
Girls, you will never guess who I've just seen. James Caan. I have been standing that close to James Caan.
What? The bloke that runs a news agency in the High Street?
The actor. He smiled at me.
Plays a lot of nutters, does he?
Sit down, Dor.
Now, I've been working on a plan to get to George.
And I picked up this from the hotel lobby.
Guided tours of Hollywood? I don't think so, Tracy.
Why? What's wrong with them?
Tours are for tourists. Tourists come from Basildon, wear cheap knitwear and watch GMTV. Now, I am more of a global citizen. I blend easily into foreign cultures.
You are a foreign culture.
Includes the homes of the stars. Stars such as Madonna, Barbara Streisand, George Hamilton.
Trace, you're a genius. We'll get tickets.
Tomorrow, 1 o'clock.
To your left is the luxurious home of Bruce Willis and his lovely wife, Demi Moore. No prizes for guessing which one chose that ghastly color.
Look at that, Trace. Makes your gaff look like a flea pit.
Not very much.
Belt up, you little germ, or I'll sew your lips together.
Next up is the lavishly decorated mansion house of Hollywood's most famous suntan, movie star and playboy, Mr. George Hamilton.
Right, let's say stop. Time to put plan B into action.
What is happening here?
It's my sister. She's having a turn. You're gonna have to let us off.
No one leaves this bus, ma'am. Company policy.
But you don't understand. She could get violent. I can't be responsible for her behaviour.
What exactly is the matter with her?
What's the matter with her? It's rare. It's very rare.
Yes. And tragic. It happened when she was a child.
What did?
The incident. She was bitten. By dingo.
God, was it wild?
Absolutely furious.
Well, perhaps in this case I can make an exception.
Bitten by a dingo? In Enfield?
I was improvising.
You were bullshitting.
Look at the size of those gates.
How are we going to get in?
Gotcha.
Nobody ever gets so far apart from my world, but maybe now that I'm...
Incredible. Tracy, do you have a crowbar?
What? They're breaking in.
No, but I'll never get those trunks off without one.
Daddy!
Come on, girls. We're getting over here.
All right. You go first, all. Age before beauty.
Listen, I need a bunk up.
George, have you got crazy women living at the bottom of your garden? I didn't think so. We better get some security up here quickly. Right. I'll stay here and guard the valuables. Right. Rest easy, little ones. Your leader has returned. Yes.
Look at this.
My best designer shorts ruined. Do you have any idea how many strange men must have seen my bottom?
Don't know. What year are we going from?
This is an omen. We shouldn't be doing this.
Shut up, you wimp.
Well, I ain't going back to that house again. They could shoot us next time.
Oh, don't worry. Could always take cover behind Sharon.
Some it'll turn up, Trace. We'll get in touch with him somehow.
Fair chance. We'll need a flipping miracle.
Attention, all you ladies. Tomorrow, Universal Studios Hollywood's very own George Hamilton will begin work on a new multi-million dollar TV miniseries.
Yes!
That's it. I've died and gone to heaven.
Leave it out, girl. He's got bigger boobs than you.
No, they don't.
If this is Muscle Beach, where's all the muscle stones? Just has a bit of seafood.
These muscles are the human variety, Sharon.
I can't eat them, can I?
No, but I could. Oh, just look at those bodies.
Oi. We're supposed to be working out how to get into the studios, not iron up the talent.
Come on.
I'm Sydney, your receptionist. How may I help you?
Hi. I'm Tracy Beckham Stubbs. We're here to interview George Hamilton for Hello magazine.
Hello! Are these people with you?
Dorian Green, stylist to the stars.
Sharon Theodopoulopoulos. They call me the snapper.
Well, I'm afraid I have no record of any interview scheduled.
Well, there must be some mistake. I jetted in from Paris especially. Didn't even have time to kiss David and Iman goodbye.
If you'd like to take a seat, I can phone through and check.
Oh, that won't be necessary. We'll just pop over there ourselves.
That won't be possible. They're in rehearsal. Hi, stage 14. This is Sydney on reception. Do you know anything about an interview with George Hamilton?
Excuse me, Sid. Could you tell me where the cars is, please? The toilet.
The bathroom's over there.
On a slash, not a shower.
Okay, fine. Hey! Attention, attention. We have three intruders on the compound. Female, Caucasian, heading for stage 14.
nice of Dawes to let us use her room, wouldn't it? Much better than the dump weary. Even the rats are putting in for a transfer.
Can you listen to me for a minute? Just say this bloke is our dad.
Oh, here we go again.
Well, what if he don't want to know us? Have you thought about that? How are we going to feel then?
It's a risk we're going to have to take, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I'm not sure I can. I learned to live with the fact that our real parents dumped us once. I'm not sure I could handle it happening again.
Who says it's going to?
Well, who says it won't?
Listen, Trace. Nothing ventured, nothing gained. No matter what happens, we'll always have each other, eh? I
suppose so.
Here's a cuddle.
Room service!
You can get going now, the food's here.
Blimey, what's all this? Fulton and Masons?
All right, Daryl. Hey, fancy a lardy?
Yeah, don't mind if I do. Where'd all this lot come from, then?
Well, let's just say I've got friends. Good friends. Oh, smoked salmon hors d'oeuvres?
Okay.
Look, Chris, the only bloke who can get hold of this stuff in here is Alfie Conroy. And he ain't the sort of bloke you want to go getting mixed up with.
Ah, he's a diamond, is he, Alf? Sweeter than that.
Yeah? That's what his mum used to say just before he dropped the heater in her bathtub. How much this lot set you back?
Well, I don't know. Got it all on tick.
Oh, dear. You really are as stupid as you look, aren't you? In fact, your looks do you a disservice. You're actually a complete moron.
Hold up, Daryl.
You're never going to be able to pay for all this.
Relax, Daryl. Look, let's just say I've got a bit of business going down, right? And I stand to make myself a nice few quid.
Oh, yeah? What kind of business?
Well, can't say it's confidential. Yeah. Of course, I ain't got no secrets from you.
Well,
but hold on, hang about.
Yeah.
I'm selling Sharon's story, ain't I? You know, to the papers. I was a superstar's love child. Well, they paid big bucks for that kind of thing. Smart move, eh?
Slimy, rotten lowlife. Stitching up your own wife for a couple of quid? Not to mention my Tracy.
Now, calm down, Daryl. I won't mention nothing about Tracy, honest. Look, have another cigar. Chocolate? Take the lot.
This is me.
Well, good night then, Dorian.
Oh, Roger, you have something on your lip.
Really, what is it?
Me. Till tomorrow night, then, darling.
If the night gets long and lonely, you call me.
Roger the barman.
So who was it? Not what you've been doing.
For your information, I have been out with Roger for your sake.
Oh, ta very much. I really appreciate it.
Roger tends bar at lots of celebrity functions. Now, tomorrow night, he will be working at an exclusive TV company bash at the Beau Rivage, LA's chicest restaurant.
Tune in same time tomorrow for another thrilling edition of Life with Roger.
George Hamilton is going to be there.
What?
Yes, and so are we. Roger has promised to arrange it as a special favour.
And what does Roger the Dodger expect in return for this special favour?
Don't worry, he's been paid in advance. The things I do for you girls.
Exclusive bash, eh? I'll have to give the velour tracksuit a going over with the old right girl.
I don't think so, Sharon. We will be mixing with the creme de la creme of Hollywood society.
Well, I ain't brought nothing dressy with me.
Right, then we will dedicate tomorrow to my second favourite activity in the entire world. Girls, we are going to shop till we drop.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Giorgio Armani. Have a look around.
Hey, Trace. Someone's left their phone number on this one. It's lovely, Trace.
This is quite beautiful. I think this is a bit young for you. Dazzling.
American, it's size 10, which means it's like size 4. These flipping shoulder pads. I thought Jolly Roger reckoned this was a flash gaff.
It is, but he said it's best to enter via the back entrance.
Well, Chris was a bit like that.
Sharon.
I just have to give Roger the coded signal.
We want you. We want you. We want you as a new recruit.
Oh, Roger.
Oh, Dorian.
Oh, blimey.
Follow me.
Try to look inconspicuous.
Not arriving in style, is there?
Oh, if only Melanie Fishman could see me now. Look, isn't that Sharon Stone over there?
Hi. Well, can I get you ladies anything?
Aroused would be nice. I told you, Dorian.
You can feed Roger the rabbit late.
Make mine a Kir Royale, darling.
I'll have a bottle of lemonade.
Pint of Heineken for me, please.
There he is. He's over there.
I'm going home.
You're not. Look at that tan. He must go to sleep for some bed strap to his gob.
Yes. I think it is time to introduce you to your father.
May I help you?
No, thanks. We're just leaving.
We'd like a table, please.
You are aware that our dining area is reserved for our VIP list?
Of course. I am a VIP.
Yeah, very impulsive pervert.
Your name is?
My name.
Yes, madam. They're very fashionable here in L.A. Simply everybody has one.
Are you?
Oh, look, okay. There's Jack and Warren. Come here. Roger never mentioned there was a VIP enclosure.
Well, that's that then. Roger and Art.
Can't believe it. I was that close to him, I could have spat on him.
I hardly think Dobbin's an appropriate form of greeting, Sam, Sharon. Look, we're not going to get nowhere near the bloke, let alone speak to him. We might as well go home.
Tracy, remember what they say in the movies. The show ain't over till the fat lady sings. Leave it to me.
Now, exactly how did you get that nasty little head wound?
Nothing. Really.
Not what I heard.
Look, 80% of all accidents occur in the barbershop. That makes me just a meaningless statistic.
If you say so. Only I heard it came from a little run-in with some female admirers.
George, I have no female admirers, and that includes my immediate family.
So I thought I'd drop in. Excuse me, I'm with these people. Look, get your hands off me, you stupid fat American. George, call me. We'll do lunch.
Is that John Collins?
Thank God you got here. Get me out of this hellhole.
Can't. We couldn't raise the $10,000 bail.
How much have you got?
Nothing.
Well, you've got to do something. This place is full of crackheads.
You mean crackheads?
Whatever.
We could always ring Marcus, ask him for the dosh.
I told you we shouldn't have come. I knew it'd end in tears. I said it all along.
Oh, wine, wine, wine. It's all you've done since we left London.
Don't ever go at her. She's upset.
Well, what's she got to be upset about? I'm the one in prison. I'm the one that's gone over the limit on Marcus's credit card. And I'm the one that hasn't got a special celebrity guest at my very own anniversary party. With gorgeous George by my side, I would have wiped the floor with Melanie Fishman's pathetic little birthday bash. You've escorted me onto the floor, as he's done with all the other great beauties of our time. Joan Collins, Elizabeth Taylor, and me, Dorian Green. He would have knocked Lionel Blair's tap dance into a cocked bloody hat.
Are you saying the only reason you helped us find our dad was so that he'd go to your party?
Well, don't look so hurt. The name's Dorian Green, not Cilla Black. No, girls, girls, you were always my main concern. About my bail.
Stop it.
Dorian Green?
Yes. Yes, that's me.
Sign here, you're free to go.
Really?
Yep, you're out of here.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Hey, don't thank me. Thank Mr. Wendt.
Who's he? The commissioner?
No, the guy you've been stalking.
Me, a stalker?
The whole town knows about you. Hey, you're famous.
This is libelous. I shall sue the entire godforsaken country.
She's a stalker, then how come you letting her go?
We had a call from Mr. Wendt's agent. Now, he is happy as a clam about the publicity. In this town, you are nobody until you've had your own stalker.
That sounds interesting. A personal stalker. I bet Melanie Fishman's never thought about that.
Are you ready? Aggie is downstairs.
Almost. Come in. Please. Look, I just want to say I'm sorry.
Yeah, we know. Sorry that George Hamilton won't be coming to your party.
No. Sorry you didn't get the chance to find out if he was your. And I'm sorry for everything I've done. I know I can be a selfish bitch.
Come on, give your hand with your luggage.
Flipping heck, door. What you got in here? I suppose nick the soap, not the bathtub.
Only the poor travel light, Tracy. Oh, leave them for the bellboy.
Right.
back to my duplex and then found I'm sitting with some of my suntan cream to make it look like it used to be.
Thanks for the tea, Mr. Hamilton.
Please call me George.
Cheers, George.
Is your friend okay?
I think she's a bit overcome. She's been carrying a bit of a torch for you ever since she was a young girl.
Well, no wonder she's exhausted. So you really thought I was your father?
Yeah. I suppose you think we're really stupid.
Not at all. I'm very flattered.
You have been to London, though, haven't you?
Oh, sure, many times. It's a beautiful city. Someday I may go back and buy it.
While you were there, you never, you know?
Absolutely not. Well, not with anyone by the name of Mavis Bullock, anyway.
Well, thanks for listening to us, George. We won't take up any more of your time.
No, not so fast now. You've come all the way from England to see me. The least I can do for you is to invite you back to my mansion for a little champagne by the pool and some sunbathing. Huh? What do you say?
You're kidding.
I never kid where sunbathing's concerned.
What are we waiting for?
What about your friend? We can't just leave her here.
Don't worry. We'll tell the bellboy to leave her with the rest of the old baggage till we get back.
Thank you, Charles. Sharon.
Yes, George.
Make sure you get right in those toes there. Good girl. And, Tracy.
Coming, George.
You missed a spot. Up a bit. Higher. Right there. That's it. Isn't this fun?
We got back safe then? Great. So did you meet him? Really? So is he... Oh, he's not. Oh, I'm sorry, Trace. You all right? Oh, good. Yeah, I'm disappointed for you, love. Yeah? Oh, yeah, of course I'll tell Chris. Yeah, I'm sure he'll be disappointed as well. In fact, I know he'll be very cut up. Gutted.
Looks really nice, Dor. Where's Marcus?
Upstairs, wrestling with his tuxedo trousers. If there's one part of his body that's grown over the years.
Sorry you couldn't find no one famous for your party, Dor. You must be really disappointed.
No. Who needs celebrities when I've got my best friends in the world around me? How do I look?
All right.
Now, don't touch the food, Sharon. It's for the guests.
Sorry to bother you. I'm looking for number 58, the fishman's birthday party.
Mr. Blair!
Yes?
So glad you made it.
Oh, yes, but
come in.
Oh. Alfie. What's it all about?
Well, Chris. I've come for my money.
For, you know you got the kind of kisses that I die for. You know you made me love you. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Darling, so George Hamilton and I were like that. There we were in his mansion sipping the finest champagne. The man was obviously besotted with me. Couldn't keep his hands off me. George, I said, I'm a married woman. Please don't stop.